morning, team. Thank you for joining me. I hope you had a great weekend. It is super busy out there right now, and Kevin and I had a blast crashing some of your open houses yesterday. If you haven't seen our Sunday adventures, check them out on our Coffee with Amy and Kevin Instagram page. So we're kicking off week two of our 60 Days of Summer program, and today is Motivational Monday. That's right. So let's talk about getting your week started off right. This week, I would like to focus on something called You Get What You Give. Over the years, I've come to realize that I'm actually a big believer of something called karma. I believe that what you throw out into the world comes back to you. And if you throw out good energy, then good energy comes back to you. When you show gratitude, the world shows gratitude back. It may not always be an immediate return, but I believe your state of mind and your energy sets the tone for how things present themselves back to you in your life. I've also learned personally that the way in which I face an obstacle or a challenge in my life determines the type of outcome I'm going to get from it. I'm not saying that it's always easy to have a positive attitude or to look at things from a positive perspective. You know, for many of us, we've had to be consciously aware of getting ourselves into the right mindset. You know, that's okay though. You know, the awareness of it is the key or the most important thing. As long as you become more aware of your approach to things in life, you're able to make a conscious effort to give out into the world what you want to get back. Let me ask you this. Are any of you working with challenging clients right now? Or are you doing a deal with an agent that is really difficult to collaborate with? If so, ask yourself this. What can I be doing to adjust my energy or my attitude, my tone, to make my working relationship with this individual better? You know, I've learned over the years that there's only one person that I can control in a given situation, and that person is me. I can't change if a person is rude or angry or short with me, but I can control my reaction back to that person. I can give them a smile, a calm voice. I can actually take a deep breath and maybe listen to them. You know, maybe I'll get a better understanding of what they're all about and why they're acting the way they are towards me. Here's another thing to think about. One of the most quoted rules is in relationship to happiness, and it's the 50-40-10 rule. The rule about happiness states that 50% of our happiness is determined by genetics, 10% by our circumstances, and 40% by our internal state of mind. Look at somebody like Thad. He is genetically inclined to be happy. I can also guarantee you though that he focuses on his state of mind in every situation. And by looking at things that way, he has a better outcome because he's more positive, even in the failures. When you're failing or something bad happens, when you're in the right state of mind, you're actually able to look at it as a learning opportunity or a moment to recognize room for improvement. When you have the right attitude, even the disappointments in life actually turn into positives. So here's what I want to leave you with. As you continue to do your daily morning routine that includes gratitude, exercise, and motivation, ask yourself this one question each day. What am I going to give to the world today? Because I guarantee if you give good vibes, give great energy, and give gratitude to the world, you're gonna get it back. Thanks, team. Make it a great week, and we will see you tomorrow for Coffee with Amy and Kevin.